Okay, so this is what I do at the gym.
When I begin working out, I usually start with 10 to 15 minutes of cardio to get my blood pressure up and my heart pumping. So now I begin to use a 45-pound weight. Yes, if you are weaker, you can lower the weight, or if you're stronger, you can add more weight, depending on how fit you are and how much you can actually lift. So then I begin to do 3 sets of 10 reps. So I'll be going down 10 times, and I'll do this 3 times when I'm at the gym. After I have completed my deadlifts, I then go into sumo squats. This is where I do 20 of these, and usually I might do 40, 60, 80, or even 100. Depending on how strong you're feeling today, you can do how many. The next exercise are deep lunges, where I go all the way down to the ground and bring my knee all the way back up, and down to the ground again and bring it all the way back up. I did 40 of these in total with a 20-pound weight. On to the next one. This is where I'm doing donkey kicks, where I kick my leg back to get a full glute reflex. See that? Up and back, up and back down. And I usually do 10 of these on each leg. You could add a weight to them, but I don't know how to. Okay, so next I'm doing an ab workout where I'm picking up a weight with my feet, which is 20 lifts using a 15-pound weight. This is an ab killer. And then I do another set of these, 20 lifts with
no
abs. And then after that, I'm doing these things called Russian twists. I do 200 of them. And after that, I do some push-ups, maybe only 10 of them because I'm not that strong at push-ups. Other things, I can do more abs. And then after that, I'm doing some flutter kicks, around 1 minute of these, which I usually tend to do about 50 or 60 of them, maybe even 100, depending on how I feel. And then these are in and out abs. You put something in the middle of it, and then you just move your feet around to get an in and out ab motion.